Hey guys, Kirkyhee here. Today we're going to show you a quick tutorial on how to defeat SQ pretty quickly. You need two things for this. You will need your speed boost, because we'll be using a shine spark to hit him, and you will also need your screw attack, which does the bulk of the damage for you. It does most of the fight, in fact. We won't be shooting a single shot in this fight except to open that door. Boy. In any case, we'll show you both the right way and the wrong way to do this, because there is definitely a wrong way to do this when you waste an attack. So first, let's show you the right way. We'll want to run all the way through here at top speed, so you'll want to run using your speed boost. Don't forget to open the door on the way through. Once you get in this room, store it before you hit that wall, line up with this spear, and use this as he's coming in through the window. And then from here, it's a matter of just hitting him six times like this. And then as you turn to black, you can get a hit there if you're quick enough. So this is two hits. Circle up and around and jump up into him. If you're wondering why I'm circling around, the fight happens too fast for me to explain it in real time. The reason I circle up and around him before jumping up into him again, a giant circle up and around like this gives him time to wear off his iframes. So by the time you come back down, take a step or two, and then jump up into him again with a screw attack, the iframe should be gone. Be careful not to do it too quickly though, because you can take damage because you'll hit his iframes instead. So that's basically the right way to do it. We'll do that a couple more times after I show you the wrong way to do it. And that should wrap everything up nicely with a pretty little bow. So the wrong way to do this is pretty much the same as the right way. Rush in here. But if you wait too long, like this, he'll spark up. And now you'll see it takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It takes 12 hits plus the 3 here for a total of 15 hits compared to the 7 you have to do otherwise. So that is why you don't want to wait too long. The moment you see him turn for this window is when you want to use your Shine Spark. Don't do the fast Shine Spark where you use your melee and then jump. You just want to use a normal Shine Spark. By the time he gets through that animation to get into the window, you'll be up there and hit him because he's within your line of frame. He's within your level. He's out in the foreground with you. So the earlier you do it, the better, but you can't do it too early and you can't do it too late. There's a pretty big 1 to 1.5 second window that you can work with. Now, I can go into further detail on just how to optimize this fight now that we've shown you how to do it. So to optimize this fight, it's as simple as, once again, getting in here, just as he's coming through this window, like now, you hold up, and then 1, 2, 3. This whole time I never let go of left. Then when he's turning black, that's 1. Go up and around. As you touch down, you can go up again, up and around, wait a second, and boom, that's the whole fight done. It really is as simple as that. This is probably the easiest fight to do in the speed run, with the exception of like the brain, but the brain where you take out the final Emmy doesn't really count. They're not a boss. They're an obstacle at best. So yeah, one more time. It's just a matter of getting in here, storing this up, waiting right here by this spear. As he's coming through the window, jump up. Jump 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 and 6, you don't even have to press the button after the 5th one. I was a hair too early there because I didn't take my step. That's what I was talking about. You got to be a little careful. And that's all there is to this fight. So if you did help happen to find this, let me try that again. If you did happen to find this tutorial helpful, leave it a big old thumbs up. I will advise you, if you're stuck around, be careful doing this method, because there's a rare chance your game can crash and you will lose any progress you made from your last save. So keep that in mind. If you're doing a speed run, it can cost you everything. So keep that in mind. It seems to be random. See, I waited too long there. It seems to be random on when the crash happens. I haven't quite figured it out yet. I don't think anyone has. It seems to be the moment you take damage on him and he takes damage on you. There's just a random chance that the game's going to crash. At least as of 1.0.3. So, keeping that in mind, be careful when trying this out. There is a risk-reward factor with it. If you can do it, it saves a ton of time if you're speedrunning. Or if you're learning to speedrun like I am. I'm currently going through the process. My best time so far is 1 hour, 48 minutes. The run's up here on the channel somewhere if you're interested in it. I'm still rusty around the corners. This is probably one of the smoothest things I did, and I relearned the fight tonight. Because I was kind of forgetting how to do it, if I'm to be honest. But yeah, if you did happen to stick around this long, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. If you want to help me on my way to next insert milestone sub here, subscribe to that button down below. Check out these videos off to the side. And yeah, I don't have too much left to say, so see you in the next one. As you can see there, he takes his damage early.